What's happening? Welcome back to a very special edition of Stacks of Wax. This time, the 7-inch series. That's right, instead of going through my actual albums and 12-inch discs, I'll be starting to do my singles series with my 7-inch vinyl. This will be much less infrequent than the other videos because I have a lot more of full albums than I do 7-inch. Anywho, let's get right into things, kicking things off. Again, this will be all alphabetical, going from top to bottom and occasionally uploading some other videos in there once I have enough to, well, make a video about it. Alright. That's enough of that crap. Let's get right into this. This is probably the only hip-hop 7-inch that I own right now, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And that would be a Record Store a Day exclusive. Anderson .Paak's Bubblin'. That would be Bubblin' on the A side. And then on the B side, features Busta Rhymes. It's a remix. It's pretty dope. Like I said, I got this Record Store a Day 2019. It's a great little pickup. And I think that my favorite part about it is I don't have many colored 7-inch discs, so this little cream see-through color is pretty cool, so I'm about it. I dig it. I'm not the biggest Anderson .Paak fan in the entire world, but you know what? Since I don't have much 7-inch hip-hop, I might as well have picked this up, and I'm glad that I did. Next begins a long trend of hardcore punk music that I have on 7-inch because, well, that is pretty much how a lot of hardcore started. A lot of it was just pressed straight to 7-inch and shipped on out as EPs or singles or whatever it might be, especially because a lot of the songs were incredibly short. This one, however, is a live album or a live single. This would be Bad Brains Live in Tijuana, September 9th, 1989. Yeah, got that right. This features their famous track Band in DC, as well as At the Movies and Pay to Come. I bought this in Austin, Texas at End of an Ear Records, which if you've never been there before, you are completely missing out. If you live anywhere in that area or are looking to go to that area at any point, make sure to check out this store because they have some fantastic stuff in there. Unfortunately, I went when I was on tour, so I didn't really have a lot of money, if any money at all. But I wanted to pick up at least one thing as a souvenir, and I figured this little 7-inch will do the job. This is an unofficial release. It is a bootleg. It just has the white label on the inner label inside there, and it is black. With that being said, for a bootleg of a live album recorded in 1989, and it's a hardcore punk single, it doesn't sound all that bad. Anyway, Bad Brains, Band in DC, great track if you've never heard it. Bad Brains in general, awesome hardcore from DC. Check this John out. Already taking a bit of a break from the hardcore scene, we have The Beatles, a little 7-inch over here, a single of Get Back and Don't Let Me Down. Don't Let Me Down is probably one of, if not my favorite Beatles song. I just really love the duet styling between the dueling guitars and the dueling vocals. This, I have no idea what type of release this is or, you know, when it was officially released. I don't know what make or label or whatever that I have of this, simply because there are so many of these out there that it's nearly impossible to track down the exact one that you have. I'm sure if I really did a deep dive on Discogs, I guess I could figure it out, but I don't really care that much, to be completely honest with you. Once again, just a solid single. I'm not the biggest Beatles fan in the entire world. Obviously, I respect them and I do like their music, but you know, I'm not too pressed to have them all on vinyl, but I am very glad that I can at least have Don't Let Me Down on a 7-inch disc right here. I do listen to this pretty frequently. Next up, it's Big Black's Il Duce and Big Money. If you don't know anything about this group, it actually features Steve Albini, as well as a couple of the members from Naked Raygun. This record is off of Touch and Go, which have released some fantastic albums over the years, including one, Slint's Spiderland. Anywho, it's a nice little 7-inch, just the two tracks, A-side, B-side, you know how it is. A little packaging in there, and it is just black, so no need to really pull that out to show you. I think you get the general gist of what this is. But yeah, Big Black, Chicago, Illinois, they do some great stuff. Just some really weird punk music that came out of them. I mean, really some interesting stuff. Not necessarily on this 7-inch itself, but some of their actual LPs really feature some creative use of punk and even almost funk in there. But yeah, if you never heard of Big Black, they're actually really worth checking out, especially with Steve Albini on guitar and vocals. It's kind of cool to see. Now we dive into my Black Flag singles. I only have a couple of them. I'm trying to complete my collection of, well, all of the little 7-inches that were released pre-Damaged. So you got Nervous Breakdown. This would be their first EP they ever released. This is just a simple repress of it because the original goes for a ridiculous amount of money. And I'm just content having the repress because I love the songs on this. Nervous Breakdown, Fix Me, I've Had It and Wasted. Yeah, I love the artwork on this thing. I say every single time that I bring up a Black Flag record, but Ray Pettibon, one of the forefathers of punk art, just really fantastic looking stuff. We also have the 6-pack single over here, another great one. 6-pack is a great early Black Flag song if you've never heard it before. And this is backed with I've Heard It Before and American Waste. Once again, these are all on standard black, nothing crazy, which is fine by me as long as it plays and sounds good, which all of these do. And finally, just because I think this track is really funny, not because I think it has much musical merit in it, but TV Party, last Black Flag single that I own as of right now. Side 1, TV Party. Side 2, I've Gotta Run, My Rules. You know, it's good stuff. I love Black Flag, as you can probably tell if you've been watching this channel for a little while. So, you know, we're gonna keep on plugging along until we can complete this collection. I still gotta get Jealous again, and... ooh, I'm blanking on the last one. I'm gonna make it show up right here because I know I'm blanking on it. Yeah, whatever. Next is probably one of, if not my favorite, 7-inches that I own, and that would be The Dick's Peace. I bought this at Bric-A-Brac Records in Chicago, Illinois. It's a fantastic little record shop over there. Just a really weird one, too. They got, like, all these action figures, memorabilia, obviously records, books, all this strange stuff all packed into this tiny little store. I really dug it. But if you don't know the Dicks, they hail from Austin, Texas. Hardcore punk. Really just actually one of my favorite hardcore bands of all time. I really love their message and all the stuff that they do. Especially on the track on side one of this 7-inch No Fucking War. Actually, I believe I just did the Spotify Wrapped 2019 thing or whatever, and I'm almost positive that No Fucking War was my number one song this year, which really doesn't surprise me whatsoever. I love this track. And then side two features Nobody Asked Me and I Hope You Get Drafted. Again, a little picture back there of the Dicks performing. Just great 7-inch. I'm so glad that I picked this one up. It was super cheap, and once again, I was on tour, so I didn't have a lot of money, so this was the perfect pickup for me. 'Cause we don't want no fucking war. Next up is another hardcore record, this time straight edge hardcore from New York City, and that would be Gorilla Biscuits' self-titled EP, Gorilla Biscuits. God, I love this record so much. I could have gotten it in the 12-inch with a couple extra tracks, but I wanted to make it stay true to its roots and just get the original 7-inch. Actually, I take it back. This is not an original. This is a repress. But, you know, I wanted it in 7-inch form. That is pretty much the hardcore punk way to do it. This is how it was intended to be listened to back when it was officially released for the first time in like 1988 or 89, I forget. 88. Check the back. 88. Off of Revolution Records, this is just some awesome hardcore punk. Hold Your Ground, one of the greatest hardcore songs of all time. Big Mouth, No Reason Why, High Hopes, Breaking Free, Finish What You Started. Yeah, this is... it's a lot of great music all packed into a relatively small disc. And it is just on black vinyl. It's the way that it is, and I'm okay with that. I was thinking about getting the red edition, but it cost a little bit more, and that is not how I do things. So, cop this. Good stuff. Nothing like some good New York City straight edge punk to really just get your day going. Last, but certainly not least, at least in this episode, again, alphabetical, 10 7-inch vinyl, singles, EPs, whatever the hell they are. We're gonna end this video on Husker Du's 8 Miles High off of SST Records, which features Black Flag, actually owned by one of the members of Black Flag, if I'm not mistaken. I always forget if it's him or not. Descendants, all those fun bands. They also had Husker Du for a little while there, and this is a really solid 7-inch. Great single, 8 Miles High, is one of my favorite Husker Du songs, and this is backed with Masochism World, another fantastic track. Husker Du in general is just an amazing band. If you've never listened to them, you are 100% missing out. But yeah, I like it, you know. If I'm not mistaken, it's just black. Yeah, once again, I was thinking about getting the purple edition. And no thank you, I'll spend less money and get the black version and still be able to listen to it. And that is all that really should matter. But, you know, Civil Repress, fine by me. I'm not all about getting the original pressings except for, you know, specific albums that really, really hold near and dear to my heart. So yeah, that is all that I have for this episode of Stacks of Wax, the 7-inch series. Once again, I'll be doing these less periodically than the other Stacks of Wax series, as I have a lot more of my real albums, LPs, 12 inches to go through than my 7 inches. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got some maybe suggestions of some new bands or songs to listen to. I know it's a lot of hardcore punk, and I'm actually trying to diversify my 7 inches just a little bit more, but I'm content with it. I don't know if you are content with it, but I'm content with it. Anyway, until next time, please feel free to subscribe, help me out, and happy listening. Peace!